Welcome to you.
I had a few scrapes and stuff, but they've washed them up and they're getting okay. And
I caught a cold, but they're giving me pills for it, and so I'm not being starved or beaten or unnecessarily frightened. I've heard some press reports, and so I know that Steve and all the neighbors are okay, and that no one was really hurt. And also that the I'm an administrator of a very set of press distortions of what's been happening. They have nothing to do with the August 7th movement. They have not been shooting down helicopters or shooting down innocent people in the streets. My hands are often tied, but not, I'm gentle. They're not. And, I'm not gagged or anything, I'm comfortable. And,
can tell that I'm not really qualified or anything. No, I'm okay. I was very upset to hear about the police rushing in on that house in Oakland. And I was just really glad that I wasn't there. And I would appreciate it if everyone would just calm down and not try to find me and not be making identifications, because they're not only endangering me, but they're endangering themselves. I'm with a combat unit that's armed with automatic weapons.
Well,
it wouldn't do any good for somebody to come in here and try to get me out by force.
These people aren't just a bunch of nuts. They've been really honest with me. They're perfectly willing to die for what they're doing. And
I want to get out of here, but the only way I'm going to is if we do it their way. And I just hope that you'll do what they say then, just do it quickly.
I've been stopping and starting to myself so that I can collect my thoughts. That's why there's so many stops in it.
I'm not being forced to say any of this. I think it's really important that you take their request very seriously about not arresting any of their SLA members. And about following their good faith request to the letter. Yes, I have. ideological ties with the IRA.
Thank you. own world, Dr. Gordon. We are the aliens, not you.
Aliens are the final step.
Ours is the colonization mission. We come from the dead world, far beyond the galaxy. As we have been searching for a new world, with an environment close to that of our own mother planet. The year is 6968. Yours is the dying world.
Dying?
I wish I could tell you the reason was natural, but I am afraid that it is man's own falling. Ours was an untimely arrival upon your planet. Regrettably, we landed in the midst of a devastating global war, a war which will leave Earth dead and mankind annihilated.
How do you plan to survive on an Earth that's dying?
We don't. There is a creeping death all around us. We cannot stay. Where could you go? We must return to the stars.
Another planetary system where it's like world.
I was in a room on the second floor. The costume room. The bar was called the Gangplank Cafe. See through the open bar doors. Into the bar.
There were some rough faces in that bar.
Some interesting faces.
I stayed in my room at night and drank wine and looked at the faces in the bar while my money ran out. In the daytime, I took long, slow walks. I sat for hours staring at
defined as not you. So the feeling of not you and the feeling of you are relative. They go together, and you can't have the one without the other. And if you can't have the one without
the other,
that means there's a secret
star
between the two.
Hope,
really the same,
light, and harmony.
The
star always brings hope.
I mean, if it was
in
all
the future,
same, it's like that song of Bob Dylan, which says,
in the future,
something like, right?
Thank you.
Dadas speaks to you, his chosen ones. You have been raised up from brutality. Kill the brutal to multiply, and our legion. This end, Zardoz, your god, gave you the gift of the gun. The gun is good.
The gun is good!
The penis is evil. The penis shoots seeds and makes new life. Poison the earth with the plague of men, as once it was. But the gun shoots death and purifies the earth of the filth of brutals. Go! And his.
Recorded live from Las Vegas, Nevada, in the marvelous United States of America. Featuring the co-host, the girl with no name, Cowboy Mike. Mr. Dunson, of course, your humble servant, Master Monkey. Tonight's episode also featured a poetry reading of Charles Bukowski and the voices of Helen Watts and Patty Hearst. So, look those up. Fine media establishments in your neighborhood. Support local business. So as we sit around here, if you like it, tell your friends, and if you don't, tell your enemies. Until next time, it's Master Monkey.